Hello, Erwan from MotionVFX. In this video, we'll see how to set up the most useful preferences in order to start with the best condition for our project.
When you launch DaVinci Resolve, it will open the project window. This is a place where you will be able to create, open, and delete projects. By default, there will be an untitled project that DaVinci Resolve will create. The first thing to know about DaVinci Resolve is that it manages all the projects with a database. Inside this database, there will be all the information linked to your project. To get access to the database, you should open the left panel on the project window, like this. By default, DaVinci Resolve will create a local database on your disk. Besides the disk database, you can have a second type, the PostgreSQL database. PostgreSQL is needed when you are working in collaboration with other artists on the same projects, or if you are working remotely over the network. A database will encompass all your projects, but you can create multiple databases, for example, one by movie, or one for a complete season of a TV show. It really depends on your preferences. To create a new database, you just have to click on New Database, then a new window will appear. You will have a choice between a disk or PostgreSQL database. You will have to name it, and for the PostgreSQL database, you will have to enter the IP of the SQL server and the login information. As I'm working alone with my local storage, I will stay with the default local disk database. On the top, you will be able to backup your database, to restore it, and to connect it if needed. I will close this left panel and let's create a new project. So we'll click on New Project. I will name it Summer in Sicily and click on Create. DaVinci Resolve will open the interface on the cut page. But before starting any editing, we will need to check some preferences. On the bottom right, you will find a little home icon which can open the project window at any time. So we can see that the project where we are is a good one. I will close the window. First thing first, let's have a look on the DaVinci Resolve preferences. You can see that there are two types of preferences, system and user. Let's start with the system preferences. Memory and GPU settings will give us some information concerning our computer, like the memory configuration that you can modify, and the GPU configuration. DaVinci Resolve requires a lot of GPU power for all the effects, color grading, and real-time playback. You can choose a GPU processing mode. Here, I'm on a Mac, so I've got the choice between Metal and OpenCL. I will stay with the default configuration on Metal. I've got the option to choose which GPU I want to use. This works if you have two or more graphic cards. As I'm on MacBook Pro, I can see the Intel graphic chipset, but this one is not enough powerful, so it is why I can't select it. But if you have an eGPU plug into your MacBook Pro, you will see it in the list. On the studio version, you will be able to combine multiple graphics cards at the same time. Next, on media storage, you can choose the location where your footage are. I recommend to not to have your media files on your system disk, so I will remove it. And add a new location, as I have a fast external SSD drive where I've got all my media. So I will select the right path until my media footage. We will see later on that it will create a shortcut for us to access to the media directly inside the media storage. Okay, let's select the Sicily project. And I will click on the media folder. I will click on Open. One important option is by default activated. This one will allow us to see all the location of the local storage or over your network. It means that if you plug a USB disk, it will appear on the media storage panel. Inside the video and audio input-output preferences, you will be able to manage external hardware to display your project on a video monitor and play the audio on dedicated speakers. Video and audio plugins will give us the possibility to check the plugin installed on the system, like the OpenFX or the audio VST plugins in my case. It could be very useful if you deal with some crashing. Sometimes it could come from a plugin, so here you will be able to deactivate them. Blackmagic Design provides great control panels, but not only. Companies like Tangent Device, Avid or GL Cooper have some control panels compatible with DaVinci Resolve. Inside the internet accounts, you can sign to various accounts, YouTube, Vimeo, Twitter or Frame.io, so you won't have to sign when you will use these online services. Let's have a look to the user preferences. First thing first, in the UI setting, you can choose your language among the list. Here I will check the gray background for the user interface, better for the eye during the color grading. In the project Save and Load, you can ask DaVinci Resolve to open all the timelines when opening projects. Regarding the numbers of timelines, it can slow down the start of DaVinci Resolve, so I won't recommend to do it. Concerning the saves, live saves behavior will save automatically when you will add some modification. You can combine it with project backups that will save multiple backups. You can define the timing every 10 minutes by default. So you will get multiple versions of your project and it will save you a lot of time. Here I will set the path for the backups on my SSD drive. On the editing section, you can create your timelines configuration if you need multiple video or audio tracks, for example. Here I will set for 2 video tracks. You can choose the audio configuration, like stereo or 5.1. You can set if by default there will be a dedicated smart bin. We will see how to use smart bin in a future tutorial. Here I will check a smart bin to display all the timeline in the same bin. In general settings, you will be able to define the duration of many elements like generators, transitions, stills. It could be very useful to set the right duration for the generator, especially if you are using our MotionVFX data packs. In this case, I will increase the duration to 8 seconds. Okay, you may need to save your preferences. Sometimes you may work on several computers and you don't want to redo all the preferences one by one again and again. So you can save them and import them to a new system. You can also reset all the preferences if you messed it up. For the system preferences, you can only reset. When you have finished your setup, you can click on Save. Depending on the changes, DaVinci Resolve can ask to restart the software to apply all the changes. So I will quit and restart DaVinci Resolve. I will open our project. If I go to the media page, I can see in the media storage that the path to my media on the SSD drive is now available. So I've got a direct access to my media. So we are almost ready to start to edit our project, but first we need to set up some project settings. On the bottom right, beside the home icon, there is a gear icon. This one will give us access to the project settings. Here you will be able to define the resolution you want to use. I would like to edit my project in Ultra HD, for example. I will set the frame rate to 25. Be sure to get the right frame rate as it will be the only parameter that you won't be able to modify after. On the video monitoring, if you don't have an Ultra HD, you can ask to see it in HD or in other resolution. Optimized media and render cache are very useful if you need to optimize your playback experience. You will be able to select the proxy media resolution. I will set it to quarter. You can choose the codec for the rendering of the proxy media. Here I will choose the ProRes 422 proxy as it will take a very small space on my disk. Optimized media is useful when you are using clips which are too heavy to uncompress or not designed for color correction. So here I will keep the original resolution and get a nice codec like ProRes 422. Render cache will be useful for effects, titles, animation or transitions. It will render them to be able to have a real-time playback, so I will use a noble codec like the ProRes 422 again. I will set all the working folder for the proxy file, cache rendering files and stills to the SSD drive. Okay, these were the most useful options to start to edit. We'll see more preferences and settings in future lessons. We are ready to create our first timeline. Okay, I will go to the cut page and with a right click, I can create a new timeline. Because we have defined all the settings previously, we can see that our timelines will have 2 video tracks and 1 audio track, and it will be a stereo project. In case you need to change some parameters just for one timeline, you can uncheck Use Project Settings and adjust every parameters. You just have to click on Create, and we have our timeline ready to receive clips. But this will be in the next lesson. I will see you there. Bye bye.